Good morning guys, welcome back to Smart Trader. Taken a quick trade in Madhusumi. I think the stock is spiking just now. I just took an order. You see the time is 9:58. I mean, it's been 2 minutes now. Stock has already crossed 0.3%. The market is negative. Yes, what you're seeing, the market is negative, but if you look at the market, opened gap down and then it went down over here and it's finally going back above. So during this time, the stocks which are in the positive side are having an advantage because market is currently going up. If I go in a shorter time frame, if you see here, market is actually going up till now. So the stocks which were in the positive side, the strong stocks which are in positive side, for example, I got Madhusumi, I took a future because, you know, I get more money in futures in normal order also. So the risk is less for holding normal order, because if it goes against me, I can hold my positions for tomorrow. So in this case, it has come up to, I have taken around what price? It is 111.65. So 0.3% will be near 112 or somewhere, right? So yeah, it has already broken the 0.3. I'm just looking into the stock. You see, this is 0.3 exactly to 112. Before that, I took Page India. If you see Page India, I have taken a position. This was a BTST because you don't see an order of previous buy. So this is yesterday's BTST and today it got triggered. A GTT order I had put, so it got triggered. So I just scalped 5,000 rupees. Just an expense. Like I told, I'm scalping out few expenses for my events. So now currently again, I've got an opportunity here. So yeah, I've just taken one lot. So one lot only will cost you around 2 lakh something in this trade. So I've just taken one lot. So if you see one lot, so close to 3 lakh rupees you need one lot. Okay. There are a lot of news going on regarding the vaccine and stuff. I was expecting that market will bounce back and, you know, it will go like a rocket. Even gold fell some 5,000 rupees. I saw some article pop up in my mobile. So gold also fell. So always understand, whenever we are doing good, the economy is doing good, gold will fall. When economy is doing bad, the gold will go up. So that's the reason you saw when this virus hit, the gold price went like anything above. And now hoping that vaccine is going to be the best vaccine right now, which has come out. If it works out, then gold prices will come down because everybody will be booking their profits. So everybody will panic that, okay, the vaccine is out. Now gold price may come down. It's the best price to sell gold. So yeah, so that's the reason you can see people selling gold and gold prices coming down. But I want to see that impact on the market. I want the market to go up, boom up. If you look at the S Bank is already 36% up. I know it's just 12,000 rupees what I invested. I don't want to risk much here. But still, you see 36% is up. Whatever FPO they gave at 12 rupees, now it is 16 rupees. So I hope the whole market bounces back and breaks its own high of 12,000 and all those. So let's see how it goes. So the current high is 112.25, which is now exactly trading over there. Just seeing it, 0.3 is done. Actually 0.3 is done, but I'm just seeing because market is recovering a bit, little bit from down, and this stock is in the top, so there is some advantage. So in intraday, this stock is moving really well. If you see, the open price is 105 and the current price is 112, so the movement is actually good in this particular stock. And the open and the low, the difference is not much big. So yes, there is a positive note on this stock as of now. But market, again, you see, look at the market, that's what matters now. Market, if market turns again down, it is difficult. But market opened today down itself. You see, RSI and all is in the lower end only. So market has opened down itself. That's the reason market is getting corrected and just going up a bit. Looks like it is breaking out the 25, just went up to 30 right now. So just seeing if it can go. There's somewhere resistance around this area of 70 to 80. These area, there is a resistance point. You see this, there is a resistance point here. Once this breaks, the stock has a tendency to go up to 114 and stuff. Depends now. I know the market is not bullish or strong bullish. Stock breakouts are difficult. But I'm just hoping this stock is doing good till now. So can it continue? Do it have, if you see, 37 lakh buy quantities are still pending and 23 is sell quantity. So even you cannot trust that, like I've told you, like operators game, you can't trust that. Anytime it can switch and turn the situation, they can book their profits from here. But I'm just seeing, can it break this 25? It didn't break 25, right? No, it's not breaking 25 right now. See, it's going a bit sideways. It is not breaking this point till now. Okay, so 25 remains the high. Even though every quantity is cleared, you know, it's not getting moved to 30. So it's getting stuck at this point. So this point has created a resistance right now. Either we need a breakout, a strong volume to break out this number. Then it'll be a good rally. I mean, it should sustain above again the at least the level of 113. So now it broke. So it has to go above 113, stay above 113 to go up to 114 and 114 plus. Okay, I think the stock is going towards 114. I mean, very fast it is. Okay. So if I say exit is around, how much is the high? 113.80. So that was a sudden spike, guys. It should sustain above 113. The price should sustain, like, so that below 113 we get a support line, so the stock can trade above this number. 114, 100 plus, almost it reached 114, like how we thought. It easily broke. Okay. Anyways, people are booking profit from that point. Okay. Cannot. This is the part which I don't like. This movement, like whether it'll go or not, and I'll be waiting. This is the moment, you know, I feel like inside. Okay, 6.5. One more chance. 6.570. Come on, break. 114 is the biggest number now. Come on. 80 lakh 40. Okay. 75, 80. Come on. Okay, I'm exiting. I don't want to wait much. I mean, enough. Little bit of greed is playing with me, so that's the limit. I was holding my finger on the mouse itself, so I was ready to click the button. Anytime a small correction also, you see, I think it came down. Yeah, it came down. Thank God I sold my position. I mean, later it may go up and all that will happen, but I don't want to hold that. You see, right, that tension will be there. What if it goes down? What about the profit you saw also won't be there, right? So all that emotional place will come here. It fell to 112.95. Somewhere I'm happy now, but if it had gone up, you may be unhappy, thinking why did you exit. But actually you should not have emotions towards these numbers. You should always be happy with number. Even though you get 1 rupee after brokerage, you should be happy. That's what I've learned from so many years. Because if you keep emotions with the stock goes up and down, and it will play with your emotions. So you need to always be happy with the money. Even if you're getting 10 rupees from the market, it's like you earned the money, right? So you should be very happy. In this case, I'm very happy. Got a single move. I captured the single move, even though the market was negative. So the market is negative. I tried capturing the opposite side. Today I have sessions from 12 o'clock today. Very less sessions because almost every classes are ending up. Very few students are pending. So yes, very less sessions. So let's see. Next trade is Indigo Futures. So the stock was spiking up. If you see, the stock is spiking. Okay, so stock is spiking. So I was trying to capture the stock spike. 0.3% is how much? Calculator, come fast. Now my brain is not working. So in these time, calculator is very important. So 984.58 plus 0.3%. is 987.53. So I will set my target to 987.50 somewhere. later whenever the stock goes there, it can book because the stock is already in the peak in a shorter time frame. In a longer time frame, it has a good movement. So I will just set it and keep. You don't know when it's gonna hit. I don't want to get stuck in greedy because I've got already a good amount of movement here. So I will not wait for much movement in this stock. So what was the number? 987.53. Always cross check the numbers, whatever you're typing here, anything can go wrong later. So 987.50. Okay, so three lots. Okay, we will wait for the orders to get triggered in some time. Market meanwhile, let me see, will it support me? Market is a little bit of two red candles right now. It's a 1 minute chart, not much. 5 minutes, it has already reached the peak. Sorry, this is Indigo. Where's market? Okay, so market is almost reaching the overbought zone, but yes, RSI has not yet reached 70 also, so it is going a bit slow up. Slope, a small slope, not very bullish or not bearish also. If you see the morning range, it is in the 1 minute range itself, close to 1 minute range. You see it is trading sideways within that, but within that gap it is going up. So I'm trying to take trending stocks only. So the target is done. It was very quick, right? So I took around 1016.43 and 1018.52. The Indigo target is done around 987. So that's the beauty of setting target. Or else what would happen, I would have sat and watched here where the price is going. See, in this case it went to 989 also. Let's see the graph how it went. It was a good capture. If I would have not captured the move, I would have not got the stock. So see, the stock was spiking, that's when I caught the stock. So that's a good benefit which I got. And keeping a target is very important because there are times, you see now Madhusumi has come down. So if I would have not exited my order there of 13,000, then it would have come down. My profit would have come to 4,000, 3,000 again. So in those cases, your mind will fluctuate and you tend to do more of trading and you miss out your target, then you lose your target. So in this case, you see, I set a target within 2 minutes. Because of the spike, it triggered. Later, it can come down also. It can go up also. So anyways, 22,000 profit. Alright guys, the next one is Petronet. I've just taken a two lot of Petronet, a normal order only. I have set a 0.3% GTT order directly. So if you see, the orders would have been directly set here. So my target is how much? 0.3, that is 252.25. So whenever the stock can go to 252.25, it will automatically trigger my sell. So let's wait and watch here. Let's look at the stock future. Currently, it is trading it near its own high. It's breaking out. I couldn't capture this breakout. By the time I looked, the stock already went up. So I couldn't capture the breakout. So let's see how much time it will take to again go up to trigger our point. Alright, if you see, the price is moving. So almost 0.18% has already been moved. Let's see if it can go further. The high is 251.95. What is my target? 252.25. So somewhere here, this is my target. You see this 25? This is my target. So I'm waiting for the target to be hit. So now it is going towards 252. I mean, the high is not created. Yes, got created now. Three more steps to hit our target. Let's see if our buyers can push and somebody can buy my quantity of 3000 here so that I get my 0.3%. profit. Alright, so finally it has been triggered. So you see the price reached to 252.25. Don't see this side, okay? You need to see the main current market price. So it has been triggered. So I had set a GTT order, if you see, that was the one which got triggered, right? Yeah, so that got triggered, and 250.25, like how we set the target, it finally hit the target. So we made some profit over there also. So it was a good scalping today, totally 4 trades. I don't want to do more of trades right now. Time is already 10:26. I have not had my breakfast or nothing. So I will go freshen up, then I will have my sessions. Later I will try to edit the video and upload by evening. So thank you so much for watching this video. Trade safe, never go back off a strategy. A single strategy will never help you. Always build on your skills of observations and learning and everything. Intraday strategies, skills, emotions. Practice the live market. That's why I say paper trade. A lot of people will think, why after 8 years he's saying paper trade? If you don't paper trade even after 20 years, then I'm sure you will not be a successful trader. So every time the market changes, you need to upgrade and learn from the market. If you don't observe, then it's like a dead end for you. So always work on your skill. If your skill is good, you will add. I applied so many other strategies in different trade here. I didn't use a single strategy in a single trade. So every trade is a different logic. So your experience and your observations, what you learned, will help you. So by saying that, trade safe, do more of learning, have patience. So learn before you earn. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the subscribe button. See you soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.